राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी
The eternal time, Yeshanam, the Supreme Lord, Anadi Nidhanam, without beginning and end, Vibhum, all pervading, Samam, equally merciful, Charantam, distributing, Sarvatra, everywhere, Bhutanam,
of the living beings,
Yat Mita, by intercourse, Kali, dissension. Translation, my Lord, I consider your Lordship to be eternal time, the supreme controller, without beginning and end, the all-pervasive one. In distributing your mercy, you are equal to everyone. The dissensions between living beings are due to social intercourse.
In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says exactly the same thing. This is explained by Kunti, devotee. The same thing is spoken by the Lord Himself. Samaham sarvabhuteshu name desasti na priya. Jyotu bhajanti man prithya teshu te mai. God cannot be partial. That is not possible. Everyone is God's son. So how God can be partial to one son and better than the other son? That is not possible. That is our mistake. We trust in God, but we make discrimination. If you trust in God, then you must be equally kind and merciful to all living entities. That is God consciousness. So, Krishna says that I have no enemies, neither I have got friends. Nami deshasti na priya. Desha means enemy. We are envious of our enemy and we are friendly to our friends. So, Krishna is absolute. Even he appears to be inimical to some demon, actually he is friend. When a demon is killed, that means his demonic activities are killed. He becomes a saint immediately. Otherwise, how he is promoted immediately to the Brahma Jyoti? All these demons who are killed by Krishna, they immediately merge into the Brahma Jyoti, Nibbishesh. The only difference is, of course, the Brahma Jyoti, Paramatma and Bhagavan, they are one. Vadanti tat tattva vidas tattvam, that is one truth, absolute truth, in different features only. Brahma iti, Paramatma iti, Bhagavan iti shabdati. Originally, Bhagavan, he is primary representation is Paramatma, who is situated in everyone's heart. Ishvara sarvabhutanam riddheshu arjuna tishtati. The primary portion, Kirodokshai Vishnu, he is in everyone's heart. That is Paramatma. And Brahma, Paramatma and Bhagavan. The ultimate issue is Bhagavan. So, Jidhanam Vibhadanti, now he is equal to everyone. It is up to the devotees or persons who are trying to understand the Supreme Absolute Truth according to their capacity of understanding. The Absolute Truth, God, is revealed either as impersonal Brahma or localized Paramatma or Bhagavan. It is up to me. The same example as I have repeated many times, just like we see sometimes the hills from our room. Here there are many hills in Los Angeles. But they are not distinct. When you are seeing the hills from a distant place, it looks like something cloudy. But if you go still farther towards the hill, you distinctly find that there is something hill. And if you come to the hill, then you will find so many persons are walking there, so many houses are there, there are streets, motor cars, everything, all varieties. So, similarly, when one wants to know the Absolute Truth by his teeny brain, I shall make research to find out the Absolute Truth, then you will have vague idea, impersonal idea. And if you become a meditator, then you will find that God is situated within your heart. Dhyanavastita-tadgatena-manasa-apasanti-jam-yogina. The yogis, the real yogis, they, by meditation, they see Vishnu-murti within the heart. And those who are devotees, they meet the Supreme Person face to face, just like we are meeting face to face, talk face to face, and serve directly. The Supreme Personality of Godhead orders that you supply me this, and he supplies. That is the difference. So, samoham sarvabhutesu, he is equal to everyone. Now it is up to you to understand him according to your capacity. So Kunti also says the same thing in this verse. Samam charantam sarvatra. Samam charantam. Charantam means moving. He's moving everywhere. Outside, inside. Simply, we have to make our eyes clear to see him. That is devotional service. To make our senses purified, to perceive the presence of God. God is present everywhere. Antabhi. Antar means within, and bahi means without. Those who are less intelligent, they simply try to find out God within. And those who are advanced in intelligence, they can see within and without. That is the difference. Meditation is meant for the less intelligent class of men. Meditation means you have to control the senses. Yoga practice means yoga indriya sangyam. Our senses are very restless. By yoga practice, by practicing different asana, so mind is controlled. The senses are controlled. Then we can concentrate upon the form of Vishnu within our heart. That is yoga system. Or those who are too much in bodily concept of life, for them the yoga system is recommended, practicing the bodily exercise and find out the Supreme Lord within the heart. But bhaktas, those are devotees, they are still more advanced. They don't require to control their senses separately, because